Father holding on to his car as he goes to Dillard University in the fall, which is her alma mater, by the way. And so thank you all for coming. I know
it's buddies. Reverend Gladney will come and offer the invocation, and then we'll just eat, and we'll come back with a little bit more later, okay? And then thank you all for being here.
Thank you, Dr. Jones. I remember that little picture that he has up there when he was a little boy, and he was riding with me in different places, and he would always look towards and stuff and spending my money.
We were running buddies.
Right. And now you came a mile long ways. And so we say congratulations to you for a milestone, and still you got a long ways to go. And we'll bow our heads, please, on this evening. We thank you for life. We thank you for the graduating classes of 2018, especially grandparents, uncles, aunts, nephews, nieces, all that goes to make up this gathering. Now, Father, we pray for the food that we're about to receive may be used for the nourishment of bodies. In your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Oh, this is real. Thank the lovely ladies of East Arkansas Family Health Center. Y'all with me? They're back there in the white. Oh, I mean, they all did this stuff. They did all of it. They decorated the room, and they, you know, the food is going to be really delicious. So I really thank you all for taking time out to do this. They didn't need to do it. And when somebody does something nice for you,
I guess who's in charge back there? What do you want them to do? Just.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I don't know this one.
I can't believe you.
was having fun. The auntie saved him. Do that move again, Steve. Make sure I got.
Hey, last time I saw him.
They grow fast.
We're going to start off with Big Sis first before this new endeavor is going to, this new world we're going to face. This real world.
Right. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Celebrating the man of the hour, my baby brother. Spence, I don't have anything prepared, so bear with me, but it has been an honor and a privilege watching you develop and grow up into this wise young man that you've become. And I'm so excited and so overjoyed for this next phase of your life. And I have no doubt that you're going to continue to make us proud. Real G's don't cry. You know, as you go off to school, like, you know, your brother and I have done that already. And I guess the best thing that I can tell you is to just stay true to who you are and don't feel pressured to succumb to, you know, be something that you're not, and just stay focused on why you're there. Like, of course, you know, you're gonna make friends, you're gonna have so many adventures, but you're there to get an education, to continue to grow and develop. So just never forget that. And I have no doubt that you're gonna continue to be amazing and make us all proud. I love you.
Love you. Hello, everybody. Thank you all for coming out and supporting young Spencer on his graduation day. I just wanted to say, baby brother, I love you. Like Jen said, I've been so proud to be your big brother and watch you grow and develop. And you know, you've become quite a young man. You're one of the best people I know. You got a great heart, great spirit. You're well-dressed. One of the most popular people I know on social media. And, you know, we all just enjoy watching you, you know, style and profile for us. But, you know, have fun when you go down to New Orleans. I hope it's the most wonderful experience. You know, college is a great, great time. I know you've talked to some of our cousins and others about it, and you know, I look forward to watching you and supporting you. If you need anything, I'm a few hours away. I'll jump in the car and drive over and be right there at your doorstep. So please share all of your wonderful experiences and developments with me. You know, I'm always here for you, and I love you.
This is my younger brother. I want to apologize in advance for whatever you said. This is my brother Phil. This is my number one dude.
Show me right. Wow. First of all, just want to give honor to God, my family, my awesome nephew, both of them.
Bag about that mic.
Sister. I just complimented on my hair. She looked like a supermodel over there. But the man in the hour, Spencer Miles Jones. A lot of people don't know that Spencer actually got his swag from me. Seriously, he got his swag from me. It seemed like yesterday, and I walked in on him looking at this movie, singing this song, and I was like, do you know what you sing? He's like, yeah. I said, well, sing it for me. He's like, my baby don't stand no cheating, my baby. My baby don't stand no cheating, my baby. My baby don't stand no cheating. Let me not be the man. Don't stand no cheating, my baby. bitch. Come on, man. That song's a little bit too old for you. He said, but you gotta be moving, huh? I said, all right, well, if you like it, I like it too. But, you know, we're gonna miss you, Spencer. I really didn't want to grow up. I mean, he's the only one that stayed up with me while we was driving, while we was traveling. Everybody else would be back there. But he's the only one that stayed up, hanging with his aunt. You know, he's more like a son to me than a nephew, you know. But I'm gonna miss him. Wish him nothing but prosperity, everything he did. If I was gonna give him any words, I always tell him to keep God first. Trust God and never die. I love you, nephew. Congratulations. Thank you.
Okay, who else? Pastor Sharon this.
Well, hello, everybody. I am so proud of my nephew, Spencer. $300,000 in scholarships. Yay. I'm representing that side because I don't want the men to get up because they'll take too long. So we're speaking for all of them. We are so godly proud of you. I know you're going to go to the top. You know I'm going to tell you, keep Jesus first. And everything you do and everything you will, you learned and everything you did in church, just keep taking it down there, singing in the choir, singing in the shower, slipping, right, busting all your teeth out, all of that, and shouting and all of your Kojic stuff. So take it on down there. And I am so proud that you're a man of integrity and character and moral standard. And I never saw anything on social media where you did anything outlandish. Stay right there. Stay focused. Stay dedicated to do what God has called you. Because you know you got a crazy mama.
Hey, sis. That's my sister there. God bless you. And for those of you who avoid a challenge, and trust me, you will be blessed. Amen. By hearing what she has to share. Thank you for being here. She's a busy lady, one of the busiest people I know. This is my brother-in-law. He's an attorney over in Little Rock, Arkansas. Ralph, come on, Ralph.
But Spencer, I wanted to say to you, you're getting kicked out of the nest now.
No, you're not. No, he's not.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. You heard what your husband said. He has to go. No, Spencer, this is the beginning of a new challenge, a new route you must travel in your life. It is an amazing travel if you decide it to be. When we all went off to school some years ago, I'm sure that you, to a certain extent, will be in the same situation. But not necessarily so, because you've had the opportunity to travel a great deal, unlike some of us older ones who didn't have the opportunity to travel far distances from home. So therefore, you will not be so homesick so readily as maybe some of us were. And you can also travel backwards and forwards back to your destination dinner to your audience. Enjoy yourself. That's what I want to tell you. Enjoy yourself, but at the same time, make sure you study to prepare yourself for whatever goals you have, whatever objective you set, and take time to really, as old folks say, smell the roses as you go. Don't take life for granted, because life is not assured to any of us. But
hello, everyone. I'm Angie. Spencer, you know I love you. I always have loved you as though you were the son I never had. Yes, I am that auntie that says and does certain things that, you know, parents probably shouldn't know. But I want you to take that thought with you to college, as far as all the talks, as far as keeping it 100, as far as the ratchet side of life. Remember that. there are good people as well as bad people out there. I know you have brain of Brandon's. I know you're coming under the blood, but still keep your guards up. Always trust in the Lord and not these jokers. And looking forward to you being successful. Enjoy.
Thanks, sis. Now, there's some
business like brothers. They all grew up together. And my nieces, and so everybody. So who else? Anybody else? All the way from Alabama, Roll Tide.
Just want to say, I did not want to come up here, but I've been nominated. I hope you do good in college. I didn't know where Dale was until now. So, okay. And I'm running a trip down in Destin. A lot of fun. Haven't seen you in a while. It's good to see you. Got a little goatee going. Okay. I'm not sure if that jacket's Burberry or not, but that's cool. But I see you. And that's all I'm going to say. But I hope you do good.
Thanks, Jordan. You know, he is a basketball player extraordinaire. Remember this name. He's going to be probably doing some big things in the NBA one day or wherever you want to go.
Thank you for Spencer for going to college. And I hope he do good and he have a great year.
You're going to need to apologize.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
God bless you. Everyone, we so grateful to the Lord to be here tonight. And I can tell you, Spencer, keep your good work going. Spencer, and singing in the choir, it'll just be a little more support. And many times, he be the only young man up there, but he let it stop him. And he kept on singing, working in the church, and that's what I love about him. Amen. And he kept the faith, amen, and up until now. So Spencer, keep the good work going on. Stay with whatever you do, stay with the Lord. Amen. And obey the Lord. And he's going to take you higher and higher. Amen. So God bless you and God keep you. Amen.
Amen. Thanks, Mark. You got a back to me. Now, these are some fun young ladies over here. Now, you want to travel with them if you want to have a good time. They are a lot of fun. And my other sister-in-law, right here, my brother-in-law, Sharon, where's Drew? Drew's over here. I mean, they are the salt of the earth. They are from Pine Bluff. Thank you both for being here. And, am I overlooking anyone else that wanted to say something? Because we have more music. I want to say this. For those of you who want to take a picture, there's a photo booth thingamajig over here. And we also want you to stop by this table back here. There are trinkets and thank you gifts for all of you for coming. I hope that you all will take one of those before you leave. Virgil's going to come. And this is my cousin Virgil, who's he's for hire. If you all get him, then he'll give me a discount for the night. So he's for hire. Elizabeth Ward Jones. Come on down.
Thank you all so much for coming. And you know, I think may I pray for this child?
So don't you stop.
And the Lord gave me such a, I don't want to say perfect child, but he gave me what I needed. I can remember, and really, and he knows this, that I wanted to have a girl.
Amen.
I wanted to have a girl so bad. And when I found out it was a boy, I was like, I don't know what to do with the boy, but God has given us a gift. And I thank the Lord for the young man that, you know, I've seen you grow up into, and you're such a God-fearing and such integrity and just loves your family. And I believe he's gonna have like probably 8 or 9 kids. He loves family. He does. He does. And, you know, I was talking to Aunt Mary in the bathroom tonight, and I just said, I hope the good Lord allows me to see the young man that you continue and, you know, what you're going to do, because I know it's going to be amazing.
Amen.
I love you, son. And...
oh, we love him too.
I just love you and just want you to put God first. And have fun in college. I mean, I think Dillard University, and for those of you who don't know where it is, it's in New Orleans, Louisiana. And I can say that, you know, I probably wouldn't be happy where I am today without, you know, matriculating through that institution. It gave me a sense of pride and just becoming the woman that I needed to be. So have fun, get your work, but have fun also. And don't forget about your mom, man. We love you.
Thank you, baby. I want to wrap it up with this. I mean, we got, again, I want to thank everybody for being here. I know there's another aunt, Chris is over there, and his Uncle Tyrone, and Uncle Ron, and Aunt Linda. Did I get all of his aunts? No, who else is in here? Yeah, cousins, Ollie and Allie, everybody. Thank you all. I mean, as I look across this room, I see so many people that really, I mean, just have been with us through it all for him. But even during one of our darkest power periods in our lives, you all were there for us, helping this family to stay together. Some of you were standing in when I couldn't be around with my son, and I thank each of you for that. And I just want to say that I agree with his mother. He has not been one woman's problem for us. He is everything that you would want in a son. Is everything you want in a son. As long as you keep God first, remember the things that we've tried to teach you, I think that the sky's the limit. You'll go places that you never dreamed of. And I'm counting on you to do that. And with that, let's have a word from our honoree tonight, Spencer Miles Jones, senior.
Well, I just want to thank all of y'all for coming out and supporting on this big night, this big day for me. Probably one of the biggest days of my life so far. I thank you all for your continued support, continued messages on social media, text messages, the graduation gifts that y'all have given that are very nice too. But if you want to give some more, you can. Need all that I can get. As I go on to this new journey, I'm just a little bit apprehensive about it. You know, I'm going to college, going to be away 6 hours away. So, you know, it's going to be an adjustment, you know, being college roommates, all that stuff. But I already know that if I keep God first, that everything will fall into place. I won't have anything to worry about as long as I keep my eyes on him. And my choice of college, it's Dillard University, has been reinstated over and over. Some of you guys might not know that it's an HBCU down in New Orleans, and one of the biggest reasons that I chose to, I made a priority to attend HBCU because I wanted a deeper sense of pride in being a black man in today's, in a world today that tries to destroy us so much.
Okay.
And I feel like Dillard University was I applied to many other different colleges, but I felt like Dillard was the best fit for me. Because when I went down there, and it wasn't because my mother was an alumni, I chose that for myself, because Dillard had such a great student life, and it was perfect for my major, and it's in a city that I really like too, which helps. So, yes, and y'all going back there, I see y'all. But I just want to thank you all again for coming. Thank you all, the cooks for preparing the food. Please give them a hand. Everybody from East Arkansas.
And serving.
Yes, and serving, of course. Everyone who decorated, I want to thank you too, of course, for putting this whole thing together. Did not know I was going to have all this and the table decorations, everything. So
That's what we do.
I just want to thank you all for your continued support, and just thank you, and thank you for coming tonight.
And just the last word, and I would be remiss if I didn't recognize my staff. I know we've mentioned them earlier, but you guys, these people often put a hedge of protection around me. They take care of me, and I know that I get on their nerves, and but they know that I want the best for our organization, and they are so dedicated, not only just to this, but to the organization East Arkansas, which plays a vital role in this community on a daily basis. You guys know that I love you, and I just, beyond my imagination, they would not let me come to work today. They said, we got this, Dr. Jones, we got all this, you just do whatever you do. But I love you all, and I thank you so much. You just don't know how much I thank you. Thank you all so much.
Claire, everybody, thank you all for being here. Teresa went to school with me. It's just so many people here. Just everybody, I want to thank you. Special thanks to my parents. Both of them are not doing well as well, but they pressed on and they're here. They didn't have as far to go as my mother-in-law, to my mother, the lovely lady over there with that jazzy blonde hair, looking hair. That's my mom. Yeah. And Spencer's other sister, she wouldn't say anything. China right there. I'm watching you. She's our adopted sister and her husband here. But thank you all. And they're our two grandbabies. But so thanks everybody. We appreciate it. Virgil's gonna come back and play us on out of here. We still have a little time left, so feel free to move around.
Trying to stay short.
Stand up. They can't see you. Hey, I am. Come on, child. We love
you. You gotta get up there.
We love you. I didn't want to stand up or say anything.
Are you standing up?
I am. I'm just short. I didn't want to stand up because I didn't want y'all to see me cry. Because I cry a lot.
In case
y'all didn't know.
Spencer,
I love you very much. Although I was very upset when I found out you were coming to this world. And I think I kind of showed it over the years of you growing up. But I am very proud of you, more than you will ever know. I'm thankful to be your cousin / sister. I know that you will be someone great in life. I know you're going to be amazing at anything you do, everything you're gonna do. I know everyone that you come in contact with, you'll bless them in some type of way. And that makes me proud of you. Your light shines further than you know. I am really proud of you. And I want you to know that I love you so much. I still don't like you, but I love you. I love you.
You're the best cousin I've ever had, and I want you to have fun, and I know you'll do great at college, and I don't want you to go, but I know it's best for you.
That's my baby.
And just want to say a special shout out to my niece, Anaya, and she's going to be a future doctor, and been trying to get her to come down, and her mother will meet. And my cousin Ollie and Alice and everyone who's here, thank you all once again for coming. And I think it you want to say something? No. Matthew? Yeah, come on, Matt.
Come on, Matt. University of Arkansas.
Matt.
because of Matthew.
Can you give my man Spencer a round of applause, please? High school is no joke. College isn't even. The past 18 years, Spencer wasn't really a cousin to me. More like a little brother. You have changed my life so much for the better. We used to play as kids. Every day, when I used to come over to your house, you were always there for me. And just like you, I'm going through this whole trying to mature as adult thing. I see you more stylish than me, so you're at least doing something. And even though I might not see you for a long time, I just wanted to say you're one of the best cousins we ever had.
If you want to come up here, utilize this floor. It's here, and have a good time.
Is that right? Huh? No.
That's his favorite song.
That's his favorite song, Phil. Well, I was going to give you a little bit of it just in case. So you've never heard it? Oh wow. Well, we're going to give you a little bit of that so you can see what your Uncle Phil was trying to put on you. There it is, young man. You going back?
Hey, we don't stand no cheating, my baby.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes, you don't stand no cheating, my baby.
I think his sister's going to be taking pictures over there by the background. So those who want pictures with Spencer.